of Brome Landau. So you've got the top that collapses down. All of these side panels fold in. It makes into a true convertible without any...
Wow. You
know, this post here folds forwards. You do have windows that you can pull up and down. They're not in here right
now.
So it's a very luxurious coach. Put the top up if you want. You can see the latch in the middle. This part folds forwards. That part folds back.
Isn't that amazing? So when you're underway, if you had to stop and pull it over, you didn't have to go back to the shop to get the pieces.
Right, exactly.
Yeah, they're made right into it. I see that.
It's very unique. You can see all the hinges on, you know, how it pivots.
Yeah.
This is supposed to have been used by the Dalton gang, supposedly. But we don't really think so because...
Look how old this one is.
Right.
It had to have candles. It didn't have kerosene.
Right. They went from candles, then they went to the oil or kerosene and then oil.
Did they use sperm whale oil anytime?
I think they probably used whale oil for a while.
Yeah. A high boy for hunting.
It's a hunting buggy. Okay, and that way you get you up high enough so you can see over, you know, any sort of brush.
Isn't that
if you're hunting out here, you can see over the creosote bushes.
And short.
So you can get
through washes and
exactly
pull you through.
Over here we've got our pride and joy. This is from Maximilian, the Emperor of Mexico, Maximilian and
his
wife.
This is Maximilian's,
Carlotta.
Yeah.
And this one was actually in an accident at one time, and another team of horses ran into the back of it. And so the parade committee, knowing that it had such great history dealing with Maximilian, what they did is they sent it back to Ohio to the Amish to have it totally rebuilt.
Oh, this was built by the Amish?
It was rebuilt by them. So
all rebuilt.
Over $40,000, and 2 years and 10 months later, we come back with this very elegant coach. You can see what it looked like before restoration.
Wow. So it was hit hard, wasn't it?
It was.
Poor thing.
So a few elegant things about
this. This was a hit in a parade.
That's correct.
Oh, in the Tucson Rodeo Parade, it was damaged. Oh, and here it is, the Maximilian Landau coach.
So a unique thing about this one, it has a step cover so you don't get your feet dirty when you get out of the coach. Very elegant.
Very elegant. Maximilian.
It also folds down. It splits in the center and folds forwards and backwards so you can have an open coach for parades or leave it up for rain. I don't know if I'd leave it up for hot. Everything was done by hand.
All the pinstriping, huh?
Hand lacquered.
All by the Amish. This was rebuilt by the Amish in Ohio. Oh, it closes nice.
It does.
Maximilian's coach.
There's actually, I was on a family vacation one time, and I'm trying to think where in the world it was. It was like Minnesota or someplace like that where they actually had a casting plant.
That made these.
And they not only made horses and calves, they also had the big Paul Bunyans, like is in
Gland. That's
from,
right.
You know, Leo's, Leo's auto parts
That's
store.
That's correct.
But they had like 12 of those guys out there with their holding the axe different ways. They had the big blue ox out there.
Oh,
also.
Babe the Blue Ox. So they made those molds, huh?
I can't remember what state it was in, but I remember going...
Now, Hatch, New Mexico, when you pull out off the road onto the interstate up there, there's a little place where they have all of this there,
too. Oh, cool. Yeah. It's a hack.
A hack.
You start saying hatch and I got
it. A hack is kind of like hack.
It's basically a taxi wagon, a depot wagon, station wagon.
Yeah.
Where you go pick somebody up at the train station or train depot and then take them to their hotel. So it's the predecessor to the taxi.
Austin Healey made the, or the Healey Company. The Healey before they joined. Yeah. So a lot of automobiles took their impetus from coach building and carriages, and a lot of old companies came this way. Mm-hmm. The Fisher body and all those. And the term Landau, like Landau tops and automobiles.
And the Brome.
And the Brome.
That's
right.
Look at that Brome Landau back there, and it's,
Now this says buggy with rumble seat.
That one belongs down over there. We're just kind of out of
sight. Oh, I see the...
Yeah, that's this one here.
That's this one. That's correct. Yeah, this... So this is some of the harness from the Maximilian. Max coach. Very much.
You bet. Yeah, just come on down January through the end of March. We're open from Monday through Saturday. From 9:30 a.m. to 3:30 p.m.
Mm-hmm.
And we welcome to bring you down. Plan on spending at least 2 hours to go through this museum.
Okay. Well, thank you very much.
You bet. stables for the city of Tucson.
The original stables.
So as you go through and you see the different departments in there, the different stores, the little cubicles,
yeah.
those were all separate stalls for the horses.
Oh.
There was a dirt floor. And then just last summer, because it's a historic building, they came in and did a study to find out where did this mud come from for the adobe.
Wow.
And they found out it came from right here on the rodeo grounds.
So, a pit, a borrow pit.
Exactly. This wall to the north of us here
has been added.
Well, it was collapsing. It was totally.
Oh, it's been rebuilt.
It was a hazard.
Since at the right. seam right here.
Right.
So but this is the original.
That's the original.
And this is restored.
This is restored. So they actually dug the dirt out of the parking lot here and rebuilt it so that it kept its historical value.
No, well, folks, I'm in front of it, and now I'm leaving. But thanks for watching KRAZ, and thank you, Mr. Martin.
That's correct.
For giving us this fine tour of the Tucson Rodeo Parade Museum. Thank you. This is our parting shot. The 90th Tucson Rodeo Parade, February 26th, 2015. An Arizona tradition.
And you can have good, comfortable seating by sitting in the grandstands.